Hello all, welcome to the lecture series of fuzzy system. In fuzzy system, we will discuss about fuzzy set, fuzzy relation, operation on fuzzy sets, application of fuzzies, application, also some terminology of fuzzy in fuzzy relation. We have discussed the fuzzy composition, so we are going to discuss in detail whole the fuzzy systems. The first is the how fuzzy set is differ from crisp set or general any set, and why fuzzy is necessary in our real cases. So first of all, why fuzzy set is necessary? Actually, in the classical theory, in the classical approach, a set is defined is a collection of well defined objects. It is a collection of well defined object or different objects. Means if we have a set A and the collection of all the vowels from alphabets, means that is, it is a collection of A, E, I, O, U. So this is a set A which contains all the vowels in the A, E, I, O, U from the alphabets. That means in this set, these are the called the elements or the members of the set. So A belongs to A because A is the set of this member. So this is belongs to that set. Here similarly, O belongs to that set A. But if we have a X universal set where you contain A, B up to Z, all the alphabets. So question is, B is belong to that set or not belong to that set? So B is also a alphabet. Here B is not a vowel, B is not in the members A, so B doesn't belongs to A. That means in a set, either belongs to that set or doesn't belong to that particular set. So X is either belongs to or X is not belong to that set. Similarly, in Boolean theory, if we have a question that suppose a name of person is honest, A is honest, is A honest, then there are two things. This statement is false or this statement is either false or true. That means here similarly, either this elements belong to that set or not, or belong to that set or not belong to this. In Boolean theory also, is this statement either true or false? There is only two options, either true or false, or belong or not belong in the classical theory, or you have to say one or zero concept. But that's why fuzzy theory is developed. The same question we have a this question can be answered in the four way. How? So very honest, but at sometimes. Lastly, dishonest. Here, that particular question can be answered in four ways. So here, Fudge's theory developed by Lofty A. Zeda, he wrote a paper in 1965 and introduced a fudgy. Fudgy means, according to Zeda, fudgy means unsharp. Unsharp means, fudgy means do not have proper fine boundaries. Here, this is a straightforward question. So, question either true or false, but in the fudgy theory can be distinguished in four ways. Either this person A is very honest or honest at some time or dishonest by giving credit by this way. Means here one, say one, it means 100% honest, that's a very honest. Honest, that means say 80% honest. If he has 0.5 degree of degree, means honest at 50%, only 50% time this person is honest. Zero means that person is not honest. So this, the value written in the right hand side is also known the grade or the value of membership value. Why it is introduced? In the classical theory, this grade generally noted as mu ax, x is the element in x, either 1 or 0. So if in the classical theory grade is 1, that means that element belong to that set. So this grade, A grade in this particular example is 1, E also 1, 1, 1, 1, but B is not belong to that, the grade of the membership is here 0. But in the fudgy theory, the grade, the membership function, it known as also a membership function, this grade belongs to 0 and 1. That means it can be 0, it can be 1, and in lies between 0 and 1 in the similar way. When Zeda proposed the fudgy theory, many people at that time didn't agree with the fudgy theory. But later on Japan, in after one decade, means at least 1976, they first manufacture or build a subway based on fudgy theory. So then later on, many countries have accepted this theory and make many application of this theory. Also in artificial, why this theory is very much important? Artificial intelligence, the main question, the ultimate cost, you can say the ultimate cost ultimate cost for machines, that think like human. In previously machines, either this is true or not true, either this statement is true or false, but in fuzzy, so the artificial intelligence based on the was based on only measurement. But to solve the thing like human, to solve that problem, we have to use perception based theory. Then Japan or many countries have manufactured many thing and apply in the machine to think like human. For example, the rice cooker, these are the applications of the fuzzy set. Rice cooker, automatic car, also in the image processing, and also the many applications of the fuzzy theory. Here, how, take one example, this is the another example, this is the first example, how you can say that particular person is honest, very honest, dishonest or honest at some time. Also, if you look another way, suppose we have a car, car 1, car 2, and these are the distance between these two car, so in classical theory only two way, this is far or near. If that car particular at that position, we can say this is near, and after this position this is far. So applying pressure on brake, it depends only near car or the distance is far car. But if you look, an intelligent car doesn't only think about near, far, and it can characterize four way, three way, or four way. So very near, far, very far. So this is car 1, this is car 2. So an intelligent car checked this car, how much distance is very near, far or very far. So he can apply the pressure to brake accordingly. That means if very near, I can take 90% brake or 0.9, or you have to grade it's a 0.9, 90% pressure to the brake. But it's a near, you can allow 0.7, far just 0.4 or 0.3, very far either 0 or just 0.1, either 0 or not. So an intelligent car think like human, it is a very near or far or very far car. So you can apply the pressure in accordingly with the membership value or with the grade value. So this is another example of fuzzy set. Also there are numerous examples. Also of in age, so in classical theory if we have this is a this is the young age collection 0 to 20 40 60 these are the age. So in classical theory this is your young age say, and this beyond it's your old age or middle age, and also after particular any point 50 so or old age. But if you think like fuzzy, you can distribute the membership function as in fuzzy we have break the way as it is, there is no sharp boundaries at if your age is this one, here it is clearly either if you have 15 years you can young age, but in this case in fuzzy the chance have 0.2 at this age the chance is 80% chance you are the young age, but 20% chance you are in the middle age. So this is the very beautiful example of a fuzzy set. In this case you can, these are the known as the membership function. Here the membership is in classical either 0 or 1. Here it can verify for the person to person, and you can say that at that particular age the 80% chance is your young age, and you can alternately say there is a 20% chance of your middle age. These are the some example of the fuzzy set.